I am a firm advocate of wearing high protection broad spectrum sunscreen every single day of the year. And one of the main arguments people confront me with when this topic comes up is, but what about my vitamin D levels? Will I get vitamin D deficient? How will I know if I'm vitamin D deficient? Which symptoms do I need to look out for? And so on and so forth. Well, let's talk about all that and why sunscreen is probably the least thing you need to worry about. If you're new here, welcome. I'm Dr. Anne, a physician passionate about skincare and well aging. To understand how we get deficient in vitamin D, we need to understand how vitamin D gets into the body. Well, there are two ways vitamin D production starts. One is in the skin, and the second is through our gut. First, the skin pathway. 7-dehydrocholesterol, or provitamin D3, is in our skin and when UVB ray hits, transforms into cholecalciferol, or vitamin D3. This vitamin D3 is then bound to vitamin D binding protein and carried off to the liver, where it again gets transformed through an enzyme into 25-OHD3 or calcifediol. Calcifediol is again shipped off, this time to the kidneys, and with the help of yet another enzyme transformed into 1.25-OH2-D3 or calcitriol, which is the biologically active form of vitamin D. The gut pathway is actually not that different. It just starts with vitamin D3 being absorbed from all nutrition alongside vitamin D2 or ergocalciferol. After that, the vitamin D3 absorbed from the food behaves exactly the same way as the vitamin D3 produced in our skin and undergoes transformation first in the liver and then in the kidneys until it reaches its biologically active form. Now, I briefly touched on vitamin D3 and vitamin D2. Vitamin D is actually a family of nutrients, with vitamin D3 being the best. You get D3 mainly from animal sources like fatty fish, yolk, liver, or dairy products, while D2 comes from plant sources like mushrooms or things like fortified oats. Both are fat-soluble, meaning that they need fat in your diet to be absorbed best. Knowing that, it is easy to understand why people get a vitamin D deficiency. Either they aren't exposed to enough UVB radiation or they don't get enough vitamin D3 from their diet. Lack of UVB exposure most often roots in the region you live in. The higher the latitude, the higher your risk. And yes, living in the UK already counts as a risk factor for that. And of course, is influenced by the color of your skin. More melanated skin needs more UVB exposure for an equal amount of vitamin D3 production. Then you need to factor in lifestyle factors like, do you ever leave the house during the day or are stuck in an office from sunrise to sunset? But even though that might surprise you, wearing sunscreen regularly isn't actually influencing your vitamin D3 levels. I have another video on that topic already that I'm going to link, but the summary is, no sunscreen blocks 100% of UVB rays and only a tiny amount is needed to produce vitamin D3, and no one really applies sunscreen in a way that covers every single piece of skin. We all miss spots around the hairline, the ears, or simply forget complete areas like the hands, the neck, or décolleté. Even under clinical trial circumstances, with frequent reapplication and defined and measured amounts of SPF given to the people, vitamin D levels were not altered. So, instead of increasing the exposure to a known carcinogen, UV radiation, let's look at the second reason, our diet. With the main source of the ideal form of vitamin D3 being from animal parts rich in fat, being a vegetarian, vegan, or simply eating a fat-reduced diet increases your risk for vitamin D deficiency. Another reason is malabsorption, meaning you don't transport the nutrients from your gut to the bloodstream, even if they are there, for example, if you have Crohn's disease, celiac disease, or pancreatic insufficiency. But even if you don't have any of that and eat a balanced diet, including animal protein, the foods rich in D3 might not be as frequent in your diet as they should be. I mean, I am an omnivore, but I don't eat much dairy, egg yolk, liver, or fat fish over the course of a month, let alone during one day. So, if anything puts me at risk for being vitamin D deficient, it would be my dietary choices and not my sunscreen habits. It is of course also possible to get vitamin D deficient through a problem later in the pathway, when you're cirrhotic for example, or suffer from chronic renal failure, but that usually presents with other symptoms first. So why is being vitamin D deficient a problem? Vitamin D is essential for strong bones, as it is needed to absorb calcium and phosphate from the gut and impacts the way they are utilized to build the bone structure. Bones can be brittle because they lack substance or because they aren't built correctly, and vitamin D influences both. It is also important for muscular strength and for your immune system, but it seems that there is even more. You can find vitamin D receptors in almost every cell of the body, and it is assumed that vitamin D is part of many important metabolic pathways that form proteins or regulate different genes. Findings suggest that it might be important for mitigating cardiovascular disease, things like diabetes, but also autoimmune conditions or depression and anxiety due to how it affects the serotonin conversion, maybe even certain kinds of cancer. And while all of that is still under investigation, it just in general seems to be something you don't want to be deficient in. But how do you realize you have a vitamin D deficiency? Which are the symptoms to look out for? Well, bones that aren't built correctly, that break at insufficient trauma, or that, in younger people, deform under your body weight are obviously an important pointer. They do appear very late though, and you ideally shouldn't wait that long. Muscle weakness and muscle pain might also point in that direction, as do frequent infections, especially from the respiratory tract. What many people do report, though, as early sign is a form of fatigue that is sometimes described as resembling a depression, not because you are hopeless or even suicidal, but because you completely lack energy and the drive to do something other than rest. All of them, though, with the exception of your bones breaking maybe, are very unspecific symptoms. The same symptoms could be caused by anemia, thyroid problems, mental health issues, or even just a period of exhaustion. While there are no telltale signs of vitamin D deficiency, the main thing I want you to take away from this video is to be aware of your personal risk and the unspecific symptoms it might present with to understand when you should get your levels checked. If you're a young person living near the equator, spending your days outdoors eating fatty fish, your risk is probably pretty low. If you're a person of color living in the UK trying to eat less fat or work an office job while being completely plant-based, it is something you should consider if you're feeling under the weather. In a study done in the German population between 2008 and 2011, 41 of the adults showed mild and 15% severe vitamin D deficiency. Talk to your doctor about why you think you might be at risk and ask for calcitriol levels to be checked. It isn't part of the regular blood work done in a general checkup. If you are actually deficient, vitamin D supplementation is the way to address that, alongside considering some dietary changes, like switching to fortified foods. Skipping your SPF is not recommended. If there's anything you'd like to add, please do so in the comments below. I will link to more videos you might find interesting on the screen, and links to my Instagram, blog, and Patreon account in the description box. See you soon. Bye.